بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. In the name of Allah, the most merciful and the most beneficent. Countless salutation on last prophet Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam. So we were discussing about pedigree analysis, Maimuna Seher. Please raise your hand, Maimuna Seher. Ji, Maimuna Seher.
सर आपने ये एनोटेशन साइन को डिसेबल नहीं किया?
ये अभी आपने रेड डॉट लगाया ना?
जी सर,
डिसेबल्ड ही है बेटा, डिसेबल्ड पार्टिसिपेंट्स एनोटेशन.
ओके सर.
जी जोनाथन जावेद.
एनोटेशन अभी तक ओपन नहीं हुई, अभी शो हो रही है.
शो हो रही है तो इसको क्या करूं? अब देखें
सर, अब ऑफ हुई है.
ओ थैंक यू यार, मुझे देसी आदमी हूँ यार, बहुत सी चीजों की समझ नहीं आती, बस पढ़ाना आता है, वो आप लोग पढ़ाने नहीं देते हैं जोनाथन. एनी हाउ, थैंक यू सो मच जोनाथन. सो वी वर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट डिफरेंट पेडिग्री एंड पेडिग्री एनालिसिस, देन वी विल हैव देन वी हैव अ लुक टू द बेसिक सिंबल्स. And now we are on categories of inheritance. So autosomal means inherited on chromosome 1 to 22. So we already discussed that some are recessive and some are dominant traits. So autosomal means inherited on chromosome 1 to 22, while sex-linked means inherited on either X or Y chromosome. So autosomal recessive categories for those diseases are PKU and albinism. You just have a look to these types of people in your family, so I don't want to explain those here much. After that, we have autosomal dominant. If there will be any you can say problem in autosomal genes and that will be dominant in family, the example is Huntington disease. Then we have X-linked recessive, in which the X chromosome has the, you can say, problem or the mutation in the family, and the allele is founding on only the X chromosome, or it can move to both male and female, as you guys know that X chromosome both and female have. And color blindness and hemophilia is the example of these X-linked recessive problems. Then we have X-linked dominant problem, in which that X chromosome has a dominant problem and moves to male and female both, and dominantly affect the male, that specific male and female. The example is hypophosphatemia. And then we have Y-linked problem, in which the Y chromosome has any issue and then moves down, and it only affects the males, as female don't have the Y chromosome. So when the Y chromosome will move to the other male or the son of that specific person that has the problem, and he just transfer his Y chromosome to his son, then that problem will be there. So after that, we have autosomal recessive pedigree. Have me a look. We have 36 slides in total, and we are on 14th one. So autosomal recessive pedigree, the trait is rare in the pedigree. When the problem is on somatic chromosomes, and it is recessive, not dominant. I hope and I believe you guys have the concept of recessive and dominant. In dominant, it express any time. It express most of the time. However, in recessive, it express less time. Recessive is less dangerous as compared to dominant, because dominant just appears in all generations almost. However, recessive just skip the generations. So trait is rare in the pedigree. Trait often skip generations. Hidden in heterozygous carriers, trait affects males and females equally. because it is on somatic chromosomes, and you know that somatic chromosomes just moves in males and females equally. However, in sex chromosomes X and Y, it just depends on the gender of that specific person. Possibly diseases that are in because of this autosomal recessive are cystic fibrosis, sickle cell anemia, PKU, and Tay-Sachs disease. So in this pedigree, you can see there we have a first generation in which one male and one female mating together, and then they have three offsprings, one son and two daughters there. Then the daughters just have married to the other guys, and they also have another family. However, son don't have any family. Still, it is a recessive autosomal recessive that has one specific trait of any disease maybe. And then there is another daughter, another female that has that one. So it usually skip the generations and it is rare in pedigree. Rare in pedigree mean rare in that specific family. If there is 100 members of that family in three generations, then there will be maybe one or two affected or five affected unluckily. So this is in the case of autosomal recessive. And if there will be a pedigree of autosomal dominant, then it usually in all the generations. And it didn't skip the generations, and it affects a lot. So trait is common in the pedigree, and trait is found in every generation. Affected individual also transmit the trait to about half of their children. If there will be four, there will be two will be affected. One, if there will be five, almost two will be affected, or in some cases three will be affected. So after individual also transmit the trait to the other, to their children, no matter if it's a son or a daughter. There are few autosomal dominant human diseases, but some rare traits have this inheritance pattern. For example, a skeletal disorder that just caused a dwarfism. You can study about that. It's a disease. So in this pedigree, you can see that the female has the problem and does just transfer to the other generation. It is parents, and this is for F1 and F2. That is generation 1 and generation 2. So you can see that the female just transfer. This couple has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 offsprings, and two were affected. And from and then this one affected one also has two affected. So you can see here in this pedigree there are three generations, 1, 2, and 3, and all of the generation has the affected ones. So this is the autosomal dominant pedigree. After that, we have autosomal dominant. In autosomal dominant, we have the example of Huntington disease, and half of the people in Venezuelan village of Barranquitas are affected. Half of the people of that specific region is affected of this disease. Maybe there is so many cousin marriages, or as you know that many people are affected, so marriages in the specific town you will have the affected person, and then we have the affected offsprings. A large scale pedigree analysis was conducted including 10,000 people. They just take the data from 10,000 people and generate a pedigree regarding the Huntington disease, and they know that every generation has the affected person. In this, they just have, you can say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Almost 14% are affected in this pedigree, and total we have 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 11, 12. After in 36, we have 10. Maybe I told you how many. 14. From 36, 14 are affected, almost half, or maybe you can say 35 to 40% are affected. So this is a figure of those person who are affected. Then there is an example of, there is a type of X-linked recessive pedigree. As we already discussed that X chromosome is present in females only. So trait is rare in pedigree, and trait skips the generation. Affected father do not pass to their sons, because a father always transfer Y chromosome to their son, and if the father has problem in his X chromosome, it will only transfer to his daughter, not to his son. And males are more often affected than females. Females are carriers, passed from mom to son. So males are more affected, often affected than females, because if there is a problem in X chromosome and female has the X chromosome and female has to transfer that X chromosome to his son. So son will be affected if the mother is affected. So here you can have a look to this four generation of pedigree, that there is a skip of second generation and fourth generation. However, first and third generation has three affected person because of this X-linked recessive problem. Then there is X-linked dominant pedigree, in which, as you know, in dominant pedigrees and in dominant problems, the generation will not skip down. All the generations will be affected. The members of all the generations will be affected by that specific disease or that specific, you can say, a mutation. However, in recessive, sometimes or usually the generation skips up. So trait is common in the pedigree, affected father passed to the all of their daughters. Because as you know, father only father has one X and one Y chromosome. And if there is a daughter, that X will transfer to the daughter. The only X father has transferred to his daughter, and that X has the problem. So surely father, if the father has a problem in his X chromosome, it surely will be in his daughter, because that X will move to his daughter and daughter has the same problems. Males and females are equally affected by this X-linked dominant pedigree. X-linked dominant disease are extremely unusual. Often they are lethal and happens in before birth in males and only seen in females, like skin lesions and bone lesions, etc. So in this pedigree, there are three generations, 1, 2, and 3. And almost all the generations are affected. And the daughters are affected because here the female affected, then X into female affected, and then two females are also affected. So then we have Y-linked inheritance, in which, as you know, Y will only be transferred to the male because female don't have Y chromosome. So if there will be a Y-linked problem, that will only be present in the males, not in the females. As father just transferred the only Y chromosome to his son, and that son will have that problem. Son again just transferred to the other one, other offspring, and then it moves down. So trait on the Y chromosome are only found in males, never in females. The father's trait are passed to all sons. Dominance is irrelevant. There is only one copy of each Y-linked gene. It is hemizygous. So you can see that here this father has the problem with Y a chromosome that transferred to that son. It has a son and a daughter. As you know, daughter don't have the Y chromosome. So it this daughter don't have any problem. The son has the problem with Y link. Then this son again has a son that has the problem. However, the other daughter don't have any problem. After that, we have mitochondrial genes. We as you guys know, mitochondria has its own DNA and coded specific proteins and genes for specific functions. So there is a big domain of mitochondrial biology, and nowadays researchers are working on the quality control of the mitochondria, and researchers just want to explore that how mitochondria died, mitophagy happened, and how mitochondria knows that which mitochondria has to die and which mitochondria has to live, and the quality of the specific mitochondria, which one is the healthy one and which one is not the healthy one. So it's a big domain nowadays that is known as mitochondrial biology and quality control of the mitochondria. So mitochondria only transfer from the mother. Father didn't transfer the mitochondria to the offspring, no matter it's son or a daughter. Mitochondria only inherited by the mother. So if there will be any problem to the mother, it will transfer to all the offsprings of that specific mother. So here we have mitochondria are only inherited from the mothers. If a female has a mitochondrial trait, all of her offspring inherit it. If a male has a mitochondrial trait, none of his offspring inherited, because you know males did not transfer its mitochondria to the offspring. In this case, we have three generations. First generation female has a mitochondrial gene problem and transfer. This couple has two children, one daughter and son. So female transfer the affected mitochondrial genes to both of the children. As you know, mothers transfer mitochondria to both the children. After that, here the son has the problem. However, son didn't transfer the mitochondria to the offspring, but the female also transferred to the offspring. So this three generation in this line has all the problem. However, this here the son has the problem, so son didn't transfer to the offsprings. That is the mitochondrial genes. So large pedigrees nowadays, a detailed analysis of dominant and recessive pedigrees. Mubeen Shah, we have okay, what you want to say, man? Please.
Assalamu alaikum, sir. Might male se kyun nahi transfer ho sakta mitochondria?
Beta, ye to Allah Pak hi is baat ka jawab de sakte hain jinhone ye design kiya hai. जैसे अब आप कल को कहोगे जी वाई क्रोमोसोम फीमेल में क्यों नहीं जाता, वो तो एक सिस्टम डिफाइन कर दिया ना अल्लाह ने. तो जैसे वाई क्रोमोसोम फीमेल में नहीं ट्रांसफर होता, मेल में ही ट्रांसफर होता है, इसी तरह मदर्स का ही माइटोकॉन्ड्रिया जो है वो ट्रांसफर होता है ऑफस्प्रिंग में, फादर का नहीं होता. ये कुछ चीजें ऐसी हैं जो कि अल्लाह पाक ने प्योरली अपनी
सर, मैंने ना
जी जी
मैंने एक वीडियो देखी थी, उसमें वो बता रहा था कि जो जो मतलब के मेज का जो स्पर्म होता है ना, जब वो स्विम करता है
जी,
तो उस दौरान उसकी टेल के जहाँ जुड़ी होती है ना, वहां पे होता है माइटोकॉन्ड्रिया. जब टेल उसकी गिरती है ना, तो वो खत्म हो जाता है माइटोकॉन्ड्रिया. क्या ये बात से मेरे को सदाकत हो सकती है?
आई डिडंट स्टडी अबाउट दैट. मुझे सिर्फ इतना ही पता है कि माइटोकॉन्ड्रिया फीमेल से ट्रांसफर होता है, मदर से, फादर से नहीं होता. आई डोंट नो द लॉजिक बिहाइंड दैट एंड आई डिडंट इवन ट्राई टू फाइंड द लॉजिक. दो साल पहले एक रिपोर्ट आई थी कि मेल कैन आल्सो ट्रांसफर माइटोकॉन्ड्रिया टू द ऑफस्प्रिंग्स. हाउएवर अदर रिसर्चर्स डिडंट एंडोर्स दैट रिपोर्ट, और उनका कहना था बाकी रिसर्चर्स का कि इसमें कोई प्रॉब्लम हुई है इस एक्सपेरिमेंट में, और उन्होंने उस रिपोर्ट को नहीं माना था. सो टिल नाउ द रिसर्चर्स यू नो have the same concept that mitochondria just transfer from the mother to the offspring, not from the father to the offspring. I don't know the reason, and trust me, I don't try to find it. It's Mubeen Shah just raised a good point. I will try to hunt out why the mitochondria didn't transfer from father. I will try to find this answer. Thank you, Mubeen. So large pedigrees we were discussing, now a detailed analysis of dominant recessive pedigrees that determine the specific inheritance type from father to son or from the first generation to the next generation, determining the genotypes of various individuals, determining the probability on an affected or affected offspring between two members of the chart. So what is the difference between dominant and recessive? If two affected people have an unaffected child, it must be a dominant pedigree. If there will be two unaffected person, the male is the unaffected, female is unaffected, however the child is affected, so it means it's a dominant trait that express in the child. However, the parents are somehow carrier somewhere. So D is the dominant mutant allele, and d is the recessive wild type allele. Both parents are capital D or small d, and the normal child is two small d's. So if in this case there will be a carrier, or both the parents are carrier somehow, or one of them is the carrier and then just transfer to the child, and child becomes affected because that specific trait is dominant. If two uninfected people have an affected child, it is recessive pedigree. The first one, the parents are affected and child is unaffected. The first one, the parents are affected, they has the problem, and child is unaffected. In the second example, we have unaffected people and child is affected. So if every affected person has an affected parent, it is a dominant pedigree. However, if the unaffected parents has an affected child, it is a recessive pedigree. So R is the dominant wild type allele. So you should be very clear for these concepts of dominant and recessive. In a very simple way, dominant happens in all the generations. However, recessive skips the generations. So here we have assigning genotypes for dominant pedigree. All uninfected persons are denoted with small d or small x. However, affected child of an affected parent and unaffected parent must be heterozygous. One capital D and one small d, because they inherited a small d allele from the unaffected parents. However, he or she just have a affected trait of capital D from one parent. The affected parents of an unaffected child must be heterozygotes. Heterozygotes, that is small d and capital D, since they both passed a small d allele to their child. So don't confuse with that capital D and small d. Just try to grab the basic concepts of recessive and dominant properties. And genotypes are just trying to denote, the capital D just denotes the dominancy and small d just denotes the recessive trait. So if there will be capital D and moves capital D to the offspring, then it will be a dominant trait. So if both parents are heterozygous, that is capital D and small d, their affected offspring have the chances of 2/3 chances of being capital D and small d, however, also has 1/3 chance of capital D and capital D. If you will draw that cross with the probability, if you just study the concepts of probability in your statistic course, then you will generate this chances of happening very efficiently. If there will be 3 child, if we try to understand it in a simple way, if there are 2 heterozygous parents that has 1 capital D and 1 small d, both the parents have male and female, and they have 3 children, so there is a chances that 2 of them will have that capital D and small d as heterozygous. However, one has 2 capital D's with the dominant properties. Similarly, if all affected are small r's, or you can say recessive and heterozygous in the same case, same will happen with the vice versa condition of the condition we already studied, that 2/3 chance of capital D and small d and 1/2 chance of 2/3 chance of capital D and small d and 1/3 chance of 2 capital D's. So similar concept is here in the vice versa concept, that unaffected children of 1 capital D and 1 small d. So here D is dominant, R is recessive. So if there is the recessive trait of capital R and small r with both the parents, the same chances of 2/3 with capital R and small, and 1/3 chance of capital R and capital R. So these are the same concept, however, in vice versa condition, because of that recessive and dominant properties. So pedigree analysis in real life, remember or recalls, or you can say explore the dominant traits that may be rare in the population, recessive traits that may be common in the population. Allele may comes into the pedigree from 2 different sources. Where and which position mutations occurs and happens, you can analyze through the pedigree analysis. Often traits becomes complex, so you can understand through pedigree analysis that at which position the trait just generated and moves down to the offspring. And you can also analyze the environment of the affected people. Sometimes it is environmental factors that just you can say damage the offspring, and there will be no genetic issues. So here we have a pedigree and the analysis with albinism problem, that is an autosomal recessive trait problem. We have 3 generations here, and you can say, you know that the half field or dot has the depiction of carrier. So here the female is carrier and here the male is carrier, two different families. So these 2 carriers just married with each other after, because both are the carriers. So out of 3, 2 of their children has this problem as a dominant, and lacks an enzyme that manufacture the pigment melanin, and result in hair and skin are very pale. So we have to understand this and analyze this specific pedigree. So you, in last, you have to tell me that the grandparents, their parents are inferred to be heterozygous, and the grandparents are the carrier of these 2 problems. Here the mother of this specific 2 affected people, the grandmother from the mother and the grandfather from the father is the carriers, and the mother and parents are the carrier one, and the children are the affected one to the specific albinism autosomal recessive disease. So here we have another pedigree to understand, in which 4 generations are presenting here, and so many affected people because it is a dominant problem, and you know dominant problem did not skip the generation, and all the members of the generation has that problem and increases. So you can say one female only here has this problem, and she has two daughters, and both the daughters has that specific dominant problem. And this daughter just has two sons transferred to the both. This daughter has 8 children, and half of them, or more than half, 5 were affected. And after that, these two affected 3 of them, and in this case, all of them are affected because it's a dominant property. So in the case of 5th one, all of his offspring, that is 3 daughters and 2 sons, were affected. However, they have 1 and affected 1, they have 4 and they have 3 affected 1. So in because of this female, the 4th generations are from out of 15, only 3 didn't affect. However, 12 of them were affected. So it's a very, you can say, powerful dominant trait that affected 12 members of the family. So an autosomal dominant trait does not skip generation and can affect both the sexes equally without any discrimination. So we have some examples of recessive and dominant human traits. You can read it that which traits are, which diseases are depends on recessive traits and which disease depends on dominant traits. So there is a chart here. We have a chart of diseases that which disease, like which type of inheritance it has, like autosomal PKU is the autosomal recessive disease and which gene is responsible for that. Sickle cell anemia is also autosomal recessive and which gene is responsible. So here we have neurofibromatosis type 1, and it is also an autosomal dominant, and neurofibromin 1 NF1 is responsible for that. So we have this example. Here we have the summary of this inherited disease, that there are 3 types of inherited diseases that we can incorporate in the pedigree. First one is autosomal, second one is sex-linked, and third one is mitochondrial. So as you know, mitochondrial just transfer from mother to offspring. However, autosomal can become dominant and recessive, and sex-linked can be X-linked and Y-linked, as we have 2 chromosomes in our sex chromosomes that are X and Y. So X-linked and Y-linked can be recessive and dominant. However, Y-linked is only transferred from father to son, and it is the dominant one, because if the Y chromosome has the problem, it will transfer to the son. So now we have a assignment, or you can say query for you guys, everyone. Draw a pedigree to depict the following family. So you have to make, okay, so how we can generate the pedigree. So now we have all the data of pedigree: autosomal recessive, autosomal dominant, X-linked, Y-linked, and Y-linked dominant, X-linked recessive, and X-linked dominant, and how many chances and probability of the chances of that specific trait or disease to the offspring, and which symbols will denote which specific individual. So we have to generate this in PowerPoint. So we have the column, or you can say box of symbols there, and that has all the symbols of that pedigree. So you have to use that symbols and generate the pedigree on PowerPoint. So you there is a software then known as Cyrillic, 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 as I remember. So that's the another software you can download from the Google, and it's very easy. Same like PowerPoint properties, there will be symbols of pedigree. You just have to click to the symbol and grab the symbol on the page, and then you have to connect the properties of that specific family. Remember, there is no software that will generate pedigree for you. You should have the knowledge of the family on your fingertips, in your brain, on your paper, and then you have to generate the pedigree with the help of software like Cyrillic or PowerPoint. So it's easy to generate on PowerPoint. So you have to make a pedigree of a family in which one couple has a son and a daughter with normal skin pigmentation. Another couple has one son and 2 daughters with normal skin pigmentation. The daughter from the first couple has 3 children. with the son of the second couple. So their son and one daughter have albinism. Their other daughter has normal skin pigmentation. So five different information is available. So you have to use this information, focus, read it very carefully, make the points on page and generate the pedigree on PowerPoint and email me. After that, you have another query. So you have to study this lecture again carefully, and then you have to tell me this specific pedigree is autosomal or X-linked. You have to give the answer of this pedigree. So this specific pedigree is autosomal pedigree, autosomal recessive, autosomal dominant, or X-linked recessive or X-linked dominant. Again, we have another pedigree, or it's the same one, sorry. So you have to tell me, not that one. So you have to tell me this one is dominant or recessive, and this one is another one in which you have to explain this one is the dominant trait or the recessive trait. So you have three queries. So you have to skip this one. No, you have five queries till now. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So in first one, you have to draw the pedigree with the specific information. Second one, you have to tell me that it is autosomal or X-linked. Then you have to tell me it is dominant or recessive. Then you have to tell me again it is a dominant property or the recessive trait. Then you have to generate a pedigree of your own family as maximum generation as you can. However, at least you have to use four different generations. First one is your generation, second one your parents, third one your grandparents, and fourth one the grandparents of your parents. So you have to collect the information from your parents on a page, and then you have to generate the pedigree. And if anyone has any genetic or inherited disorder in his family, he or she has to mention. So you have five different queries and you have to solve those. First one, you have to generate a pedigree of that specific family by using the given information. Second, third, and fourth one, there are three different pedigrees available, and you have to analyze the pedigree with the help of this lecture. And then you have to answer the question, is it dominant or recessive or X-linked or Y-linked? And then you have to generate the pedigree of your own family, and you have to mention minimum four generations. Ask questions from your family. If you have grandparents with you, ask questions from your grandparents, how many brothers and sisters they have, and how many is there any genetic or inherited disorder they have or you have. Please mention and generate a pedigree with PowerPoint. Thank you so much, everyone. If anyone has any question, please raise your hand. जी बेटा मेमुना सहर 9324
सर ये आपने जो प्रीवियस जॉब असाइन की थी ऑब्जर्वर की सर उसके रिजल्ट नहीं आ रहे अभी तक सर वो कब तक आएंगे किससे
बेटा होप सर्वर पे
मैं जो जी सर वो जो फॉज उसके अंदर
कौन सी प्रोटीन ली थी बेटा आपने प्रोटीन बहुत लेंथी प्रोटीन होगी आपकी या आपने रैंडमली उसमें म्यूटेशन दी थी कि आपने लिटरेचर में से पहले फाइंड की थी म्यूटेशन
सर लिटरेचर में से तो मैंने रीड किया था तो नहीं मिली थी बट ये था जो सिस्टिक फाइब्रोसिस जो है ना
जी जी
उस डिजीज के लिए सर वो प्रोटीन तो लेंथी है लेकिन वो मैंने चूज की थी
तो आपने म्यूटेशन बेटा रैंडमली दी है
जी सर
तो बेटा वो फिर टाइम तो लेगा ना रैंडम म्यूटेशंस नहीं देनी चाहिए थी आपको लिटरेचर में से फाइंड करना चाहिए था अगर आपको लिटरेचर में से नहीं मिली तो आप यूनिप्रॉट में से देख लेते यूनिप्रॉट में से नहीं देखा आपने
सर यूनिप्रॉट से तो मैंने उसके वो जो है ना वो डिटेल स्टडी किया था उसको
चलिए फिर आप उसका वेट करें वो इंशाल्लाह ताला जरूर रिजल्ट्स आएंगे बेशक आप उसको ईमेल अपना दे दें जब रिजल्ट्स आएंगे आपको ईमेल आ जाएगी अदरवाइज वो स्पेसिफिक विंडो मत बंद कीजिएगा अपने ब्राउजर में से वैसे ब्राउजर बंद करके आप लैपटॉप ऑफ कर दें जैसे ब्राउजर्स में ऑप्शन होता है ना कि जहाँ पे बंद किया है वहीं से ओपन हो तो वो विंडो स्पेसिफिकली ओपन हो जाएगी जब भी आपके रिजल्ट्स आएंगे ठीक है वेट करें आ जाएंगे क्योंकि बहुत सारे लोग सर्वर्स यूज कर रहे होते हैं तो कई मरतबा सर्वर डाउन हो जाता है COVID-19 की वजह से बहुत सारे सर्वर्स डाउन है क्योंकि उसको मेंटेन नहीं कर पा रहे लोग वेट करें आ जाएंगे रिजल्ट्स
थैंक यू सर
एनीवन हैज एनी क्वेश्चन प्लीज रेज योर हैंड्स Okay, thank you everyone for joining.